Authorities are about to give new details on their investigation into a series of stabbings that happened in Virginia, Michigan, as well as Ohio. Now, since May 20th, people have been attacked. These are the police talking now out of Atlanta. Let's listen.
Airport Division received a phone call from Michigan State Police concerning a suspect in a series of homicides and assaults. Our officers were advised that the suspect, identified as Elias Abuelazam, was waiting to board a Delta flight to Tel Aviv, Israel. Three officers and a sergeant from the airport precinct were dispatched to the gate where they had Mr. Abuelazam paged over the intercom. He was taken into custody without incident when he approached the ticket counter in response to the page. Mr. Abuelazam was transported to APD headquarters and later the Atlanta City Jail to await questioning by Michigan State Police. The Atlanta Police Department's airport precinct is proud to have participated in this apprehension, but it's important to note that the investigative portion of this case is being handled by other law enforcement agencies. Out of respect to their investigation, we will not be discussing any further aspects of this case.
Did your officers know at the time that they approached him that he was a suspect in these serial killings?
That's why Michigan police called us. Yes.
Did the officers know? Were there any precautions that were taken there at the gate to make sure that he was taken into custody safely, that no passengers were?
I don't have the details on that. I just don't.
Is there any way you can go into his demeanor? You say he was paged and willingly walked up. Talk a little bit about that and his attitude.
I don't have the details on his demeanor, but one can assume that the fact that he approached the counter and was taken into custody without incident, that he, you know, didn't resist us, but I don't have any information as to his precise demeanor.
Do you know if he knew that police officers were in that area when he came to the gate?
Well, we actually weren't in the area when he was at the gate. We got the call from Michigan State Police, and we dispatched our officers from the airport division to the gate.
I guess what I mean is, when he got that page over the intercom, and he walked up to the desk to identify himself, at that point, did he realize that police officers were onto him?
You know, I'm not clear on the actual timeline of whether the officers, you know, called from their phones and said, page him and we'll get there, or if the officers were standing at the ticket counter. I really don't have that information, but I can try to get that.
You know, speak about the.
Let's go ahead and bring in MSNBC analyst Clint Van Sant. He's a former FBI profiler. So, Clint, we're listening there to the Atlanta Police Department.
Yeah.
I know that right now the FBI is also involved in this, and here we have the Atlanta Police involved, and they're giving a briefing, and we also expect briefings today out of Michigan, also Virginia, and Ohio. So what are we learning now from the initial reports from Atlanta and the fact that they were able to identify this person as the person, the suspect that they wanted to nab?
Well, as we've heard in this part of this press conference, the task force up in Michigan, state, local, federal agencies that were working trying to identify this man, one person is believed to have killed five and wounded another 15, developed information, enough information that led them to believe this guy was going to catch a plane out of Atlanta, Hartford, going to Israel. Authorities had a name. They had something to go by. They may well have been following him based upon either license plates that could have been parked at a parking lot or, in fact, his cell phone. They knew enough to page him by name. When he showed up, of course, they found out he had an expired Israeli passport, so trying to leave the country on that expired passport itself would be reason to hold this man and question him. Now, of course, we're going to find out more if the authorities can link him to these crimes. But remember, Thomas, we're also told that this distinctive vehicle that he was driving, this Chevy Blazer type of vehicle, 5 to 10 years old, with a green color and two grapefruit-sized dents on the front hood. This vehicle that has been identified by victims has also been recovered. So it seems like the authorities are putting this case together pretty quickly, and as we hoped and as we've discussed, would end this crime spree based upon help from the public, which is probably where some of this information was developed.
Clint Van Sant, thanks very much for your insight on this. We do appreciate it.